So, today I'm going to talk about how one can actually train to become free of all the negative characteristics of samsara. Yeah. This is a very important practice to do, because if one does not train in such a method, then truly one seems to be practicing Dhamma, but in the end is still being so absorbed in a drama. then Dhamma then becomes difficult each other. We and Dhamma are difficult to become each other. Difficult to become selfless and become Dhamma, and Dhamma become us, oneness. So I was thinking, what's the best way to teach for everybody to be able to practice Dhamma, is that everybody need to have these few points that is very, very important to become skillful cultivator of Dhamma. And so, first thing is we have to understand this point. The point is that the very important point is to to realize and to see that all sentient beings are visitors and guests. The problem is all sentient beings, including ourselves, don't realize that we are visitors and guests. And we become so caught up with being a visitor and a guest, and thus we are not free. For example, it's like going to the beach to play in the swimming, or to play building sandcastles, or playing at the sand. Somehow then suddenly we become so caught up with if the sea water is clean, or if the sand is of good quality, or if I will get sunburned, or what is the right method, and this and that. And so, and even you must say, if we go to the beach to play sand, then we even have to buy the beach. Then becomes totally, even though it may sound ridiculous, but this is what we are. The moment we want to enjoy something, the moment if we like something, we need to own and we need to possess it, because we are so insecure. We are so insecure, and we saw that we must own it. It must be in our name. It must be some kind of a document or something like that to say that we own this thing. So insecure and so caught up with all these unfortunate things. So, like the God doesn't know that he's a guest in the God realm. The devas don't know they are born as a guest in the deva realm. We as a human being also don't know we are a guest in the human realm. Guest, right? So, animals also don't know they are animals. They are guests. They think they are real. We think we are real. We think whatever we do is real. And we feel that it is real. Our job is real. Our work is real. Our so many things has to be in this or that way. It is so real. How are we ever going to freaking become liberated? What is the liberation? We're Buddhists, we know how to use the word liberation. Actually, the liberation all the while is there. But we are doing so many things to chase or create a new liberation. For example, a good example, to have fun is just to relax our mind. Even anything you do can be fun. Even folding a paper aeroplane and throwing it, it can be fun if you just put down. But the thing is that our idea of fun today has to be psychedelic color, has to have some brand and some name and some form and some place and some... So many things to create this a different level of fun. Happiness is the same thing. When we talk about happiness, what then is happiness? Your happiness, my happiness, everybody's happiness is very different. But when did we last allow ourselves to become happy? So this is important thing. When did we last put down our ideas and identities of things just to enjoy the simple pleasures of life? That itself can have a happiness. But we ourselves create things to cheat ourselves. Like for example, there is one job, this difficult job to do, but because it is a high working for some rich and famous person, and an influential person, and. And the influential person, and then while we are there working, and then everybody says, "Wow, you're working there, you know, this is if you don't want to work this job, a million other people want to take this job. You know, if you don't want, you know, you are doing the job where everybody wants to work, but it's not a happy job. It's a good name, good fame. It is depends on what kind of person you are. Some people just want, you know, to be seen with the rich and famous and this and that. But can we really just say, let's just sit down and we can and enjoy whatever situation that we are in. Right? I give you a good example. Another good example, if the weather is hot, you can switch on the air conditioning system, switch it on and become cool, right? That is the main purpose, isn't it? Keep cool. Then somebody comes and tell you, this brand better, this later model, this one got this green light here that tells you that it's okay. You know? And then this one, the remote control, has got dual function. What do you need a dual function remote control? You need the switch off and on, and temperature up, temperature down, and fan speed, that's all. But the main thing is, we ourselves, what do we really need? We need this air conditioning to cool the place down. But the main thing right now is, you want this brand. You want this brand. You know, the salesperson comes and tell you, you want this brand because this is what is good for you. You need to do this. You need this brand of car. It's good. It's made in Europe. It's got whatever technology and this and that. But what's the purpose of the car? So when we say that we want to be liberated from suffering, but yet we ourselves, because we fail to see we and each other as guests in the world, in this existence, right? Even we are guests in the workplace. Your workplace, you are playing that work, that role in that workplace. After you go home, your role change, and you're no longer that, and you're a guest in that workplace. You are paid to manifest that form, to do that particular job that brings value to the company, or that other people need or cannot do, that you can do it. But right now, many of us have become to believe that our worth is our job. Our self-worth and our confidence is in our job. Then you have no life. Because the name, fame, recognition, power, money, all comes from job. Then, of course, people have no life. They cannot have to sit down and enjoy the cup of tea, sit under the tree and just, you know, slowly sip your cup of tea, enjoy the breeze, or just enjoy the moment, the friend. Yeah. So because people fail in samsara, all samsaric beings fail to see themselves as guests, then so much importance upon the whatever thing that they believe that they are, even so much suffering, so much of upkeeping to do. Right? There's so much upkeeping to do. That's why there's suffering. Last time I'm this, like now, or maybe somebody got, even the student, you know, in school, I became top 10%, I must always upkeep the top 10%. There's no room for failure, or there's no room for underperformance. I think when I was in school, I myself also always pressured to deliver the results, right? Until when I went to monastery, and then my teacher says, More important is you can perform the duty that bring benefit to other people than the name, fame, honor, or result. Good example is person who cook the food at home. Person who cook, who goes marketing to buy the food and then to cut and wash and keep and cook. This is so much work to do. Eating is the easiest part. Okay? But the one that get no recognition is the one that is cooking. No recognition. The person cooking, the person doing the housework, there's no recognition. Do the most job, get least recognition. Of course, then, you know, who feels good doing that? Right? And you can see, now, our families run by helpers or maid. They do all the menial work. Actually, those are the work that we are supposed to do. But somebody else do it, and then you pay them a little bit of money because you think that is like a quite brainless job. Huh? But that is the, your life is dependent on them. They want to put drugs or anything inside your food and then you die. Huh? So, when you can see that we ourselves and each other as guests in a samsaric bowl, including the beings that are not the same form as us, like the animals, like other people, or when other people say that, oh, praying to this God is good, praying to that God is good, and so much is saying that, oh, maybe this saint or that saint, or this special power or this deity or this and that, you know. To me, frankly speaking, I'm not bothered. Right? Personally, I'm not bothered. If I'm doing the practice, I become. You know, so all of us, my advice for all of you is to remember that some of you always come and tell me they have bad dreams. Bad dreams or inauspicious dream or this place is haunted or being disturbed by spirits and this and that. So, what is your practice? Your practice is to face them and then you dissolve yourself. And for those of you who are practicing Tantra, then you arise as your own idam. When you can arise as your own idam, you've got the divine pride, divine confidence, right? Because the deity does not have his own personified personality. But we have personified personality, that's why we need to dissolve into emptiness. From there then arises as a divine body, divine speech, divine mind. So the thing is, body is deity, speech is mantra, mind is wisdom. If we look focused to understand, this has no personality. Didn't say what deity like to eat, what deity like to drink, what like to wear, what like to do, what are the likes, what are the dislikes, don't have. Right? So when we do practice. If somebody say, oh, this is good, this is like this, like that, then you can ask, why? Proof. Right? Definitely, if it comes from lineage of gurus, then you can ask. It is not something that grow out of nothing. Right? So, when we are this, when we can see that everything including our own self and the environment and our work or your business and the things that we do as like guests in this phenomenal world. Yeah. Why I say phenomenal? Because everything is a phenomena. It is no real meaning to it. And so when we can see, then truly now, on the first line of the Heart Sutra says, Bodhisattva Mahasattva Avalokiteshvara meditate on profound illumination. Which Chinese actually is more accurate in the translation? First five words of Heart Sutra in Chinese, what is it? Yeah. So when, as the Bodhisattva Mahasattva, to be able to practice, to cultivate a liberated Bodhisattva Mahasattva to cultivate unanchored within samsara. Unanchored within samsara. Then one is able to observe and to hear. Observe and to hear with the mind abiding, with the mind abiding in profound peace. Right? Our mind to abide in profound peace. Guan zi zai. Zi zai ma. Right? Guan yin pu shi. Guan yin. Right? To observe the form and the sounds. Guan yin. Right? The phenomena of smells, phenomena of sounds, phenomena of taste, phenomena of touch, phenomena of vision. Even though we may see that and agree that everything is the same between you and me because we may have the same low karmic capability. But for some people have maybe more special eyes, born with more special DNA, and they're able to see and to observe things that we cannot see, maybe more different colors. Some children can see in the night. Some children cannot see. We can see some in the darkness, but as we can see, as we know, there's such a thing called night blindness, right? But when we can see, they cannot see. So when we can see, what we can see, we think we are already seeing, but for those beings who can see further and see more, what we are, see, we are night blindness. Buddhas, Bodhisattvas see us like night blindness. We are suffering like having night blindness. Right? We are suffering like night blindness, not able to see. Not being able to see beyond the dark. That's why we say that is called ignorance. We only see as according to our own karmic condition. What we like, what we don't like, And when things move beyond our karmic capability, and we seem to be in control. Then what people suddenly say, what people want to be in control, they like to say things like, "Are you challenging me? Are you challenging me? Are you doubting me?" Right? Becomes a threatening or threatful kind of speech. Cannot win by logic and reasoning, then use seniority or something like this to get away with things. Okay? So there's so many things that we sentient beings that we do. We say we want to be free, and we say we want to be liberated, but whatever we do is the direct opposite. When we say we want to be free, that means you can be the ship or the boat that is unanchored. That means the boat can go anywhere, it's still floating on the surface of water. That is to be, you can be free. Free means not anchored down, and free means floating and can go anywhere, and the boat still floating, still can enjoy float on the surface of the sea. But ourselves, there's so much focus on right now, what brand is the ship? What brand is the anchor? What brand is the chain? What is the brand of the motor in the ship? You see, we say even though we want to be free, within that freedom there is virus. Okay? Within, in ourselves, in our practice, within that freedom, there is virus. So, what we really need is, we need antivirus. When you got antivirus, you can, like your antivirus in your computer, you can go around the internet without fear. Right? So, the main thing for us to understand about our Dharma practice is, we first of all is to realize, very importantly, to realize that all beings are guests. And because all beings are guests and they do not know that they are guests, that they are doing so many crazy things, that is why you can become like Buddha, like Avalokiteshvara. The first five words of the Heart Sutra, Guan Zi Zai Pu Sa. To see and to sense. But the mind is abiding within the realm of profound peace. The bodhisattva abiding in profound peace. There is all seeing and all hearing. That is the meaning of the first five words of the Heart Sutra. Okay? If not, we just observe whatever, so many things that we do, and other people do. What happens? People get angry with each other. People think about profiteering from each other. People think about doing things to each other, or harming each other, or gaining from others, and this and that. So many things that many beings do. The truly is an anchoring and scarring each other. That's why it is a very important that when we can see this, we don't criticize those beings who cannot see, because if you criticize those beings who cannot see, then again there's, where's the compassion? Because if you can see and the beings cannot see, then that means you have more wisdom in a more developed state, and therefore that we really need to cultivate skillful means. Skillful method is the direct capability to become Buddha. Because skillful methods is the direct contact with sentient beings. Direct contact with sentient beings means doing the activity of Buddha. Because if no sentient beings, there's no Dharma. Okay? Like this, a bodhisattva, bodhi is the mind of bodhi itself, is superior. But some people think of bodhi, they say it's called a bodhi tree. Right? So, since all things, all phenomena have no permanence and are just empty of therefore they are just an illusion, empty of their real, they are not real, so they are empty, they are like ghosts. All phenomena, all things, all beings, every single thing. And if we become so real, then we are so affected in such a real way with other beings, and it affects us, then really we know what is our level of Dharma practice. Give you one very good example. Being, people say, called the feeling of being in love with somebody. Okay? Attachment or in love with somebody. Actually, this feeling of love has no eyes, no ears, no nose, no mouth, no body, no mind, right? Correct? Right? This feeling of love. Right? But this feeling of love can trigger everything of you. Your ears, your nose, no, your mouth, your mind, your body, your speech, everything. This thing that in fact has no form, no sound, no smell, no body, nothing, can trigger every single thing to go haywire. Make you laugh, make you cry, make you this, make you that, go up, go down, or everything come out. So then what is this feeling of being in love or in hate? If you're not in love, means you end up, you hate the other person who don't give you what you want. That's the reason why Buddha said, for those who want to become monks or nuns, then you have to know relationship and to be celibate. So when we realize this, right, something that is so nothing but can make everything happen, the feeling of being, the feeling of in love, the feeling of attachment, this is called binding. I'm yours, you are mine, you are, I'm yours, you are mine, I'm yours. I want, I need, I this, I that. Actually, it's the same, but wow, the binding cause ties so tight. Actually, what is there? Nothing. So, many people say, oh, this is called karmic debt. Your karmic debt, lah. Your this and that. Many things. Everybody wants to so many things to say about everything. Again, so many things to say about many things. You got so many things to say about something that is an illusion that shows you yourself also. You yourself also seem it like the illusion. Right? Okay. So that's why when people ask Lord Buddha some kind of question, the best answer Buddha gave was just a smile and kept quiet. For example, questions that people ask the Buddha, how old is the universe? What is the beginning? When is the end? When will I become Buddha? When will I become your state? Buddha smiled. How can you become Buddha? If you believe that you are real, where can that Buddhahood exist? Where can that Buddhahood exist? Where is the space for? It's like, you know, the stone believed that it's solid, you know, solid like a rock. Yeah. And the solid like a rock say, when can I become rainbow? Right? Because they believe this, the shape, the weight, the density, everything believe is real because the rock is really heavy, really dense now. You know, and this rock asks the rainbow, when can I be you? What can the rainbow say? The rainbow will just be like a rainbow. Right? So the Buddha, gurus and the Buddha, just be guru and Buddha. Anyway, whatever people do, whatever other people do, rocks will be rocks. Fire will be fire. Whatever one does, most important is therefore is the motivation. Why some people say, oh, why is the reason like this? Why is the reason like that? Because the reason is samsara. That is why we have to make the firm affirmation to be free from samsara and to become a Buddha. Ourself, the things that we do, so attached to the idea that we are real, or that right now my body cannot means I cannot, then it's impossible. Then it's impossible to evolve. For example, if somebody believes that he or she is fat and will be fat for life, it's impossible for that person to become, to slim down, to lose weight. Okay, impossible. Some men believe that they can only do this. Some women believe they cannot do that or cannot this, and they can only enjoy something like this, and the men say they can only enjoy something like that, and that is the only way, then this is so saying that I am a rock and I can only be this heavy. I am a rock, I can only be this dense. Right? But the main thing is rock can become, grind the rock together, mix with other things, can become concrete. Rocks can become the best material, best thing, is used as the best thing to sharpen knife. Right? So if the rock sees a knife come, and the rock says, wait, I'm a rock. I cannot sharpen the knife. Right? So the identity of the knife is being very hard, and the identity of the rock is being very hard. Is this what we are now? When you learn some Dharma, when you practice something, it's very good. We know it's very good. It's like, you know, a rock go in the shower and take a rock to shower. Right? But the rock didn't get less rocky. Yeah. What we should really become is we should really become soap. Whenever there's water, we lose a bit of ourselves. Reality is our life is more like soap. The more you use, the less you have. Then by the time you finish, then you are dead. But at least the soap is beneficial. Right? So this is some things that are very important. Yeah. Then the thing is that in samsara, why this another big joke? That big joke in samsara. They put things on their body and give them a value. Okay? Like putting different color stones and calling them rubies and turquoise and what chakra stones and this and that. Huh? We take pieces of metal and form them into things and adorn the body that does not exist truly. And we also create something that make believe and make us all suffer so much for a piece of paper called money. Right? We suffer so much for a piece of paper called money. When you open your wallet, if there's a beggar, Adam was very kind. He donated $100 to somebody in New York City. Yeah, the person asked him if he got change. So he thought that person wants to change money with him. The person took his $100 and ran away. Actually, it's like robbery. It's robbery. Or stealing. So I said, you $100 to learn something valuable in life. Right. So what is money? Who created money? Do we actually even need money? Do we need money? How come, if you think about it, if I am a hermit living in a cave, does the cave has any value in terms of money? But does the cave have any value in level of protection? Right. So same in your house. How come today your house has this value and after some years the house has becomes less value and after some years the house, the value go up and down? Who created it? Everything is the same. Who created the values of ups and downs? And after that, there are other human beings who created different platforms or styles to read the minds of other people who are playing the ups and downs and make money with other people's mind that makes things go up and down. And our life is always chasing after other people's ups and downs. So truly, if we say right now, for benefit for all sentient beings, we want to become Buddha to benefit all beings, Start now. We have to start now and not think about not think about all the other things that you are thinking. Remember, yourself and all beings are guests. And you go to somewhere else that you are unfamiliar, you see other people quarreling, fighting, and this and that. Will you get involved? Will you get involved? No, right? But why are we so involved in this life then? Why did we choose to believe in other people's quarrel and other people's ideas? Or why did we allow other people's things to affect us in ways that is so unbelievable? So let's not talk about this one. Now we say that now we are already affected. We are already affected. How? Right? Don't want to be in love, already in love. Don't want to fall in love with somebody else, already fall in love with somebody else. With some more than some more, 1 L's, a 2 L's, a 3 L's, a 4 L's. How? Huh? Right? Fall in love with one person, then fall in love with another dog, then fall in love with another jewelry, then job, then colleague, fall in love with somebody that polish your shoe or polish your apple. Huh? Right? So many things. We fall in love with so many things. Yeah. That's the thing. We fall in love. We didn't rise in love. We fall in love. So, when this thing happened, what is the most important thing to do? Please remember my advice now. Everybody will tell you to let go. Forget about it, lah. Okay? How can you let go? It's my advice for you now is don't focus on the letting go. Right? If you think about letting go and you cannot let go, it'll make you feel worse. Right? And so, the best thing is to best thing is to open up and to become vast. To become great again. Oh yeah, I learned. Make America great again. Yeah, make yourself great again. Actually, this is my poor translation. I was just thinking in Chinese. 不是放下, 是要放阔放宽. Oh, it's not about letting go or putting things down. It's about 放阔. I say 放阔放宽. My translation may be to open up and become vast and become great. Right. It's not about putting down, it's about breathing. It's knowing the space, increasing your space. So many of us have this problem because we always think about all this. Then my feeling how, then my thing, how the thing is going to affect me. So my advice for you is not about thing. Don't focus about the letting go or putting things down. So Elsa's song about let it go, no? Yes. I think I feel it's outdated. They need to come ask me for advice. Make new Disney song. Is it Disney?
Yes.
A new Disney song. Yeah.
Right.
Right. Many people say they want to let go. So easy to let go. So easy to let go. Right. Those who are not married have other things to cannot let go. Those who are married and with children, worse. Much worse. Right? So easy to let go? No. So it's not a matter of letting go, but to make it great, to become, what does it mean? That means you have to become Mahayana, Thekchen. Mahayana, Thekchen, Ta. Great is the collection of small. That means you have to be accepting. 能够容纳，能够接受，就叫大，大称。大是能够容纳种种的小。 All kinds. One big plate can put a lot of fried rice. What's in fried rice? Rice fried with rice? No, right? There's so many different things inside the fried rice, right? So you just remember this. Okay. To be vast, to be great, is to be accepting. Accept and to know, to accept and to cultivate skillful conversation. Right? Like some people I know, even my temple staff, so many of them, there's so many, how many things supposed to like this? Oh. Some people ask me, staff also ask me, outside people also ask me, students also ask me, what is the method, what is the way that I know how to get things done, and who is the one that, how to get people to empower me, how to get people to give me the power and the this and that. All right. And to get recognition or empowerment to do the work or recognition or whatever success that they feel that they have done. My answer is this. I think the difference is whether you are a boss or you are a leader. If you are a boss, you are relying on other people to recognize you as a boss. But when you cultivate and have all the leadership qualities, as you, not within you, but as you, automatically you are leader. Automatically people want to listen to you, even though you may not have political power. Maybe you do not have a big company. Maybe you don't have a great name, fame, honor. But when you are just have all these leadership qualities and things like that, you may not. You don't need to look for name, fame, honor. Name, fame, honor come and look for you. So then is the difference. Then is how we should practice Dharma. It's like many people ask, or they want to practice, they want to pray so that they can do well, and they can good business, and they have a good interpersonal relationship, they have a power in their speech, and people will listen to them, and this, I say, all for the wrong reasons, right? The right, if we cultivate to have all the leadership qualities and capabilities, everything will come by itself. Right? Don't need the boss or the general manager or whoever, or maybe, you know, to empower you to make things like this or like that. Right? Many people say, oh, need empowerment, that have to, who is doing what, so that everybody will listen to this and that. What if that person is a cockroach or lizard kind of character, you know? Or birdman character, you know? Yeah. You know what birdman character? Birdman, you know birdman? Huh? Right? Yeah. Not gentleman, birdman character. Then, even though you may have everything, people is not like you. You can have everything, but people not like you. Right? So, you see many people, right, on the top have no friends. Right on the top have no friends. When you reach the top, what's the next thing that happened? Come down, roll down. Right? So it's better to just to be. When, and many people ask me, what's the best thing to do? The best thing to do is to lie down on the floor. Best thing to do is to become the floor. Right? You can support everybody else. Right? Right? The best thing is to be the supporter. Right? Be the pillars, be the beams. Right? Don't be the roof tower. Right? Be the pillars and be the beams. So that is very important in our practice, to be to support and in that way, yeah, automatically many things work out. But most important thing is the first five words of Heart Sutra I told you just now, and to see all other beings, as including ourselves, as guests in this phenomenal world. And remember, no matter how shitty things are or how good things are, it won't last. It won't last. Right? Remember my analogy of being of the boat and the anchor. Right? You're floating on the sea, but your anchor is there and you cannot go anywhere. What's the point? Okay. So there are many, many things I spoke about tonight. There also, remember, you should also remember about the difference between being a boss and being a leader. Yeah. Many people are followers. Because they, not that because they are lousy, but because they did not practice on the skillfulness of expression. Yeah. If you cannot express yourself, how can you help other beings express themselves? Right? Who is great? You are great only if you can help other beings express their feelings and emotions when they are not capable of doing so. In other words, if you can let other people's voice be heard, right? Not your own voice, not your own wants and capabilities and this and that. Right? So, recognize these points, then our life as guests in this phenomenal world will be better. It's easier to become liberated. Instead of chasing after becoming Buddha, Buddhahood just is already there. Okay? Thank you.